My father was farming. Yeah, he was raising cotton, corn, peanuts, and peas, and potatoes, and things like that. Yeah, my father got killed when I was 3 years old. I was coming to be 3 years old when my daddy was killed away from the family. He was kind of a rough man, you know, and people didn't like him, and he'd fight rest march, you know, and he had killed a man, so. So he went to the penitentiary, and he come back, and he married my mother. From then on, he started this family, the Hopkins family. So just as I was coming to be 3 years old, well, they put someone up to kill him because he was rough. And he raised good crops, and he gambled, and he'd win the cotton. They'd win the people's cotton and all that such as that. And they didn't like him, part you see, because one time he went a man's mule and wagon, but it didn't belong to the boy. It belongs to the boy's daddy, see. But still and all, my father, he still tend for his money, but he give it up to the boy because he wasn't, it wasn't out of him. He just gambled it all to him, so. And from then on, you know, like that, it just come to be worse and worse, you know. And the old man, he didn't love nothing but gambling, drink whiskey, and fight and shoot and go on. So that's the way his life was taken, you see. So I left nobody but my mother to raise us children. In fact, the business mama, she raised us the very best she could. And, she did wonderful by us all. She did a mother's part, you know what I mean? Because she couldn't expect to be did by the kids like a man could do, but she did the very best she could. So she kept us living. So I seen it hard on mom, and I just got out on my own. So now I helps my mom. Well, I was in and out because mama was there, and I would go away for a year or so, and I'd come back to see about mama. I'd always ride her, but the other oldest boy, he left. Shortly after my daddy got killed because he was big enough to remember how it was, you see. And my mother, she didn't agree for him to kill the man that killed my daddy. That's what he had on his mind, and he said if he stayed there, he would do it. So he told us, well, I'm going to leave, because if I don't, I'm going to, you know, kill that man. So he did. He left, and he said, I'm not coming back. And he didn't until here about a few years ago, we found him. He wouldn't even write or let, he told people, don't even tell us where he was. And he wasn't far. He wasn't over 200 some miles from his whole family. But he stayed away 28 years before we found him. That's right. I was 34 years old. So I was 6 years old when he ran away. Well, he didn't run away, he just told us he'd gone. When he first left, he was gone for a year, he got sick, he come back home to us. He come back home to us, he was there for about a month, and he got well. And he said he didn't come to stay, he just was come to get well or either die. And he couldn't stay, and he left again. And that last time he left, he was gone for them 28 years. So we haven't been too long ago finding him. We all got back together. We's pretty well together now. He's in Waxahachie. My mother, she lives in Centerville, which she's in Houston now with her granddaughter. And, you know, around there with me and my wife and all. So we's doing fine. My other brother, he's in Gaston. My sister, she died 2 years ago. So I just left the three boys. See, my other brother, he got killed 17 or 18 years ago. And that just left three boys and a mother now. So that's the family.